Guys,
so how familiar were you with Beast Boy? You know, I mean, he's such a fan favorite character. You know, were you already a fan, or you know, did you dive deep into the comics when you got the role?
I was. I had said this earlier. When I moved from Japan to America, Teen Titans was actually the first animated series that I not found relatable, but it was similar in style, the animation style, to something I would watch back home. So, Teen Titans was really the first animated show I fell in love with, and Beast Boy in particular, the way he assimilates to cult, like humanity, because he's green, like because he's an exile or a reject or whatever you want to say, his use of pop culture and I guess pop culture knowledge to integrate into humanity and to make friends, I use that as a model to when I didn't speak English, like when my English was rough, I used pop culture and toys and music and movies to be able to relate to other kids at school. And yeah, I mean, it's full circle, man. Beast Boy's been a part of my life since I was 7. So, yeah.
So what was it like then to suddenly, you know, become Beast Boy, you know, to get that?
It's freaking bizarre, man. I feel like I'm dreaming. Like, this doesn't feel real at all. But, you know, it's fun, but it's also a bummer sometimes because you almost want to be the animal. Like you almost you want to tell yourself like, yeah, I'm Beast Boy, cool, yeah. And then you go and you're like, all right, so we're doing the tiger transformation. And you're like, I can't actually do that. So CGI, please.
What do you think about the CGI tiger?
To be 100% honest, when I first saw it, I was a little disappointed, but since then, they've done multiple passes, and I'm really happy with how it's looking, especially for a first episode of a first season. Like, you know, whenever you watch television, I think viewers are becoming smarter. The production value of everything just increases over time, and to have the tiger look the way it does straight off the bat, I think it's a testament to how much effort they're trying to put into the series, and especially attention to detail. They could have just focused on Robin and the suit, but you know, they took the time in making sure the green of the tiger was right. The transformation of the tiger looks anatomically correct. The amount of work they put into it is
those very dark shows we were talking about. But Beast Boy often adds levity and humor to it. Is that going to be what your kids are as well?
It will be. I think the only way that Beast Boy is grounded in this series is, I guess, the physical comedy that was a fan favorite in the Teen Titans animated series. There's only so much I can do because I can't physically turn into a cat and make, you know, like a cat face to react to something. So a lot of the humor is just Beast Boy's a genuine heart in juxtaposition, in contrast to how dark the world is. Episode 1, you see me very briefly. Episode 3, I started to kind of integrate, and people will see how every character is introduced and the relationships between each one. It's a slow burn, but I watching it, it's worth it because you're waiting for these characters to show up on screen. Like, I'm liking everything so far, so where's my favorite character? And, you know, throughout the series, there are more and more characters introduced, so I can't wait for everyone to see this boy.
which episode are you most excited for fans to see?
I am a huge fan of John Fawcett, and he directed the Doom Patrol episode. That episode, to me, is closer to the tone of, like, the Teen Titans that everybody knows. It's a little bit more humorous, but still, there is the grounded, dark reality of everything, but it's a little bit more vibrant and colorful, and, you know, the characters are quirky, and you're meeting these family members, and that is by far my favorite episode, simply because I'm in it. No, but in all seriousness, I think it's the first time we get to see the Titans kind of in action, and
when you were researching the comics, the original Wolfman Perez issues, did you have any favorites, any Beast Boy moments or stories that like stuck out in your mind?
I actually made this hat when the Titans go camping, and Gar makes like shirts and hats for everybody, and Starfire wears it, you know, unbeknownst to what it says and the arrow and all that. That is Beast Boy. He's just trying to make people smile and laugh the entire time. And there is the hat. Yeah, there's a level of, you know, narcissism that Beast Boy has that I try and maintain. Beast Boy was an actor, right? You know, he had a short-lived acting career that not many people know about.